this video, we're not just going to be painting our little Pict chappy here. We're also going to be trying out a new stand that I have for my phone. It's one of those gooseneck ones which clips on. I've got it clipped to the my unit and it's hovering above us, so hopefully this is going to pick up the sound better than the camera was doing. So if you hear any funny noises, we have noisy beggars outside, plus we have Ali watching something on TV in the bedroom, so she might start laughing after a while. So there we are, that's part of it. So let's start off with, shall we? We've got the flesh going on first, it's Bugman's Glow, and we're going to add that to our palette. A nice dollop of that, because I don't just have this particular one, I've got 14 others to go, so that's what happens there. Next, we want a little bit of Screaming Skull, and this is going to be used to brighten up the, or lighten the Bugman's Glow, so we're going to have quite a bit of that put on as well, like so, and we're going to stay there for the second, for the time being. We'll come back to anything else that needs doing as time goes on. So we're going to start off with our flesh colour, and we'll get some of our Bugman's Glow. And we're just going to use it. I mean, this has been, if you remember, this has been washed. So what we're going to be doing is, now we're not washing it again. What we're going to do is, we're going to go over it now with the original colour that the skin was, over the little lumps and things that show off the musculature and the tone of the Pict body, and that's going to pick out. In fact, I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to get a smaller brush for this. It's not exactly what you call adequate for the job, so we're going to use, let's say, a smaller brush. So we've got a brush here, and we'll just, let's say, over any of the raised areas, we'll add some of this colour. Like so. It's the usual for when it comes down to highlighting things. Pick the raised areas, and then, or find the raised areas and then pick them out with the colour. That's what we're trying to do. Anywhere that you think is going to be quite dark, oops, leave dark. Now we don't have to go leave it tremendously dark at this point, because we're going to be coming back and adding another highlight colour to this. We can do a few other places with this colour just to pick out detail, but when we come back and do the paler colour, then we need to just pick out the ultimate highlights. So we can pick out and make sure that the skin tone looks universal. So, universal, what am I mean about? Looks, what do I mean here? We can just make sure that the skin tone looks, not universal, standard is the word I was looking for, all through this. because the one thing we don't want is darker bits here and lighter bits there. And even though that is quite often natural to have such discrepancies, shall we say, and differences in skin tone when you're painting models, it doesn't look right. It might look natural, but it's not right. It doesn't look right when you're painting a model. It needs to be more standardized color. So that's what we're going to aim for. Now I just need a little bit of water on my brush. There we go. And we'll do the thigh here. And toes. Calf muscle. As I say, we're just going to go over with near enough every raised area with this colour at the moment. And then later on, when we come back with a lighter shade, we're painting only the bits that go, or the only bits that are going to be hitting the light, or the light's catching it. Another thing we need to do as well is look at the veins, because there's a lot of veins in this, because it's muscly. You usually find that a lot of, when people are muscly, they have a tendency to see being very veiny as well. The veins can't hide very well, they're very prominent. So we'll be looking at that as well. You can see that there's a little vein running down there. The hands are very veiny. And also I've got 15 of these all together to do. This is good. This is number one. Or rather, this is the first one I'm actually highlighting. It's the last one I've base coated. So if you want to call it number 15 or number 1, whichever, doesn't make any difference to me. But it's going to be a busy session for me painting these. Eek. But I want to show you how to do at least one of each mini. As you can see, there's a lot of little lines in his face, and trying to pick all them out can be quite hard work. So if you do actually cover any up, don't worry about it, it's not vitally important. There's a lot of wrinkles in his forehead. So don't worry if you do accidentally go over them. You can always say this guy had Botox. And so just go over all the muscles and the raised parts. Once we've done all that, we'll add a little, we'll get a dollop of this and a dollop of that. Predominantly more. Of the Bugman's Glow to the other colour, the Screaming Skull. So we don't want a lot of the Screaming Skull in this yet. And now we're going to start picking out the raised areas. Not quite some water, a little bit better. Hopefully that'll be better, let's put it that way. All right, and just pick out the raised areas. And we keep doing all this until we've run out of raised areas to paint, and then we do something else. Very subtle colour difference at the moment, so don't worry if you can't really see much of a difference yet, but you will do by the time we've finished. This is basically an intermediary colour for the finishing highlight stage that we're going to be using shortly. It's just so it's not a great big difference in the that previous step and the final highlight colour, so it's a bit more natural. You'll see what I mean shortly. Oops, just clobbered up the camera again with me. A little head loop. Yes, I'm not just using my reading glasses, I'm also using magnifying head loop as well, and that way I can see roughly, or see much better what I'm doing. Hope you can follow on what I'm doing as well. Some areas I'm going to do just to pick out the detail more than actually pick out where the light is going to hit, because as I say, sometimes detail can be lost and you really need to emphasize some of it, otherwise it's not going to look right. Yep. One thing we want to do is make these look right, not necessarily natural, but right. There is a difference. And as you can see, we have a lot of the muscle tone done now. From above to make sure that I've got all of it that I need doing done. Oh yeah. And now what we'll do is we'll clean our brush off and we'll get some more of the Screaming Skull added into this mix to make it a much lighter colour. And this colour then will be the colour that we're going to be using to extreme highlight the skin. So get some water on our brush and then into this extreme highlight colour. Knock off some of the bubbles of water or droplets of water that's on the shaft of the brush, and now just the uppermost areas will get just a touch with this colour, not going overboard and certainly not covering up everything that we've done previously. Making very, very delicate and careful movements around the face or facial area. There we just run 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 there, and same again down here. And here we are, we're just making sure that the skin tone is highlighted there. We need a little bit on this side because I haven't got any. Pick out the knee there. And there we have our Pict Warrior skin highlighted. The next thing we have is the loincloth area here. Now this is going to be highlighted with a grey colour. If I can find the one I'm looking for. Well, it's not actually grey, but it's a greyish colour. Have I got it? Did I dig it out? No, I didn't. I thought I had. That's a little bit. What on earth have I done with it? No, it's not that. Is it that one? It's that one. Got it. It's more browny grey colour. And it is Rakearth Flesh. Now this is going to be gently dry brushed onto it. I'll need to just give my dry brush a bit of a wash because I've had the soap preserver on it, Master's soap preserver, to keep it clean. So now after that I need to just give it a, make sure it's completely dry before I dip it into the paint. And let's say it's raccoon flesh, so we'll give it a shake. We will get some of the paint onto the brush, close the lid, rub some off onto the paper, and just, I'm going to say onto the paper, it's a paper towel that I'm using to just clean my brushes or dry my brushes on, rather. And just do that onto there like so, and then the same again on here. I'll also do it over the top edge of the wood on the axe. There we are. And that's that bit done, that was easy enough. Now the hard part is the fact that the skull on there and the bones here haven't actually taken to the white. So I'm going to have to add a little bit more white onto this. So it's going to be a little extra step that I'm going to use it straight from the bottle. I'm just going to make sure these are covered in the white, and then once I've done that I will go over once again with the Agrax Earthshade wash, and that should do the bones. And it's just here, and mind you this skull seems okay. I'm just going to gently dry brush over. That doesn't look too bad. I'll do the same, just gently, a few gentle swipes like so, and that will suffice for that. I don't want to ruin my brush by going doing anything else with that, so I'm going to put that brush to one side and get my dry brush out once more. And again, this is going to be another dry brush. Oh, the white I'm using, as you may have guessed already, is white scar. I'm just going to gently get most of that off, and then just there we are. And that's it for that. That's all I'm doing, nothing more. Touch on to the there like so. And that's that. I might even just gently go over the her with this white as well. And there we are. That is the Pict Warrior done. That's all we're doing with him. There we are. So once the white has dried on the bones on the back of his loincloth, the kind of thing that he's wearing. Then, and it probably should be now, it is. I'm just going to give it just that once over with a little bit of Agrax Earthshade, because it doesn't need too much done to that. So I'll just do that now. Looks like so. Also do the same again to here, just to darken it slightly. And that, what is having a totter about, and that is basically it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope the in fact I'm going to reinforce all the bone areas with that. So there we are. So that's it for this video. I hope you've enjoyed it. I have 14 more of these to go, as I say. But in the next video, they're going to be doing something completely different. We might even not do a Conan one for the next one. I'll find something else to do instead, just for a bit of variety. But this is the Pict. I'll move those out of the way, so this is the only focus of your attention. There we have it. I've just realised what we could do. A little bit of Screaming Skull. And just through the top edge of his toes to show toenails. There's not much in the line of fingernails to see. Ah, there is something I have forgotten to do though. And that is veins. Now I want to use a little bit of this mix. A lot of the Screaming Skull. I want it to be very, very, very pale colour from what's already been done. That should do the trick. And now we can go and do all the veins. I don't want them to be too different to the I don't want it to be too different from the actual skin tone. There we go. And there's one up there. You know, when you see models like this which have the big veins sticking out, you can just imagine the hard work that's done by the sculptors to get it right. We have done the veins in the shadowed areas. I am going to be going back and emphasizing the shadows with another wash, so it will darken them down quite a bit. But I'm just making sure they'll get all of the veins done. much as I can actually see. I think that is it for veins. That one across there. Okay, that will do. I'll just wash this brush out and then go back in with the Agrax Earth Shade. Give it a shake. A little bit on the brush. And just go and accentuate the shadow areas with this so the veins don't show too brightly against the shadow. There we are. And that's it for this video. There may be bits I've missed. There's a little bangle there. I'll just notice, so I'll do both wearing bangles. Now there's a bangle on each wrist, so I'll just get a little bit of the screaming skull. And just go over the edge of it. There we are. And oops. On this side as well. Da 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 da. I'll emphasize some of the bone area here with a little bit of this colour as well. And that's it. There we are. Right. I don't think I've missed anything else. If I have, tough, it can stay missed. That is it. Oh dear. That is it now for this video. I've had enough of this fella. I'm going to go and do something different. So until next time. As always, take care, God bless, and bye for now.